Yes, I am.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure.
So, okay, so today is our Wednesday class, and this will be a class of our joints and glands practices that we have been doing, which we regularly do, to help us with the self-possession. And this self-possession is a process of coming into the mind-body in a integrated fashion. And so it's referred to as smriti. That's an interesting word in Sanskrit. It's S-M and R in Sanskrit. It's a special type of vowel sound that is retroflex. So if you take your tip of your tongue to the roof of your mouth and you say R, right. So you say smriti. Smriti. And when it gets written in English, typically you write S-M-I-R-T-I, just because we don't really have that vowel, way of writing that vowel. But they write the letter R and they put a little dot under it. And that signifies that it's one of the 13 vowels. Sanskrit has 13 vowel sounds.
Is that, yeah.
Yeah. So it's really a beautiful language, and it takes into consideration all of the sounds that we're able to make in our, you know, our speaking habits. So English maybe in a way as a kind of a sort of an efficient language in some sense, you know. And in other ways it's very inefficient because it takes a lot of words to say one thing. So smriti means self-possession. And that's really what our classes are about each time, is our joints and glands exercises, is to do something to really integrate the body. So we begin with our breath, and we begin by sitting tall and letting the feeling of the breath enter the nostrils, and you first feel that warmth of the breath as it first comes in the nostrils. It's cool, and then it becomes warmed as it travels as one stream from that entrance in the nostrils into the space behind the eyes . And as we breathe, we notice the natural movement of the breath in the navel and abdominal regions, the lower borders of the lungs, the front of the rib cage, the sides and the back of the rib cage. We just notice the natural flow of the breath traveling from the nostrils into the space behind the eyes, and then the movement of the breath in the body. We begin the class with a little invocation to the golden womb. So, and so for something to happen, we need a literal and a figurative womb. We need a place for it to become, grow from a seed. And so the intention of a thought before it becomes clothed in words and in images begins as a notion, perhaps a feeling sense. And that's the origins of our practice. Swami Shri Rama. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. And continuing with this sense of the movement of the breath flowing in the nostrils, we've made that connection with the breath entering the body, flowing into the center of the skull and into the abdominal region in a wave-like motion. When you begin your next exhalation, you may begin the head and neck series. So as you exhale, lower your chin to your chest, just folding in, let your arms dangle beside your chair, let your spine round in, just like you're a letter C or a rag doll, just rolling up. And as you inhale, begin to straighten out your spine again, lifting your chest a little, drawing your face up. Maybe your shoulders can roll and arrive on your back. As you open your neck and your exhalation begins the other process of rolling in, letting the spine roll in, letting the shoulders roll in, letting the spine round towards the chair back behind you, just like a large letter C. And as you inhale, the wave begins to open your spine, open your heart region. Maybe your shoulders arrive on the back as you take your chin up. And you can take several breaths. If you're finding that your breath, if you want to move a little slower than your actual breathing rate, you can do that. But if you're wanting to adhere to the movements connected with your breath, really just follow your own inhalation. Don't worry about how other people are moving. Don't worry about how I'm moving. Let your own inhalation open you up. And as you exhale, let your own exhalation take your body into the C shape so that you're getting the flexion and extension of your spine. Your spine is like the flexible qualities of a bow, of an archer's bow, and it has four curves in it, just like the archer's bow has. If you're all familiar with Cupid's bow and arrow, you can see the shape of the bow in your mind, and you can see the four curves to it. And so you're just opening up those curves, lengthening them, and then letting them go through their shape, their natural shape, and then you sort of flex them the other way. So you're bringing a little conditioning and toning to your spine, and you're stimulating the spaces between the vertebrae, letting them stack up one at a time. The vertebrae, those that are not fused together by surgery or perhaps by various bone conditions, have soft material between them, the discs, and they're like little round cushions. And as you rotate and move the spine, those cushions are getting squeezed on one side and released on the other. So we're really aware of this therapy for those spinal areas. And then once we've done this for 8 or 9 times, after we reach our final inhalation and we exhale just to our vertical position, we stop and pause for a moment just to reflect on what we've just done. Just taking awareness of how the spine's feeling. Noticing any tensions, perhaps little tensions in the hip area. Letting the breath flow. And now, where our exercise number two, which will be done with the breath as well. So bring your awareness to your right ear, this right side of your head, excuse me, and your right shoulder. And on your next exhalation, let your right ear descend towards your right shoulder. And as you inhale, feel the head come back up in its vertical position. And the exhalation now takes the left ear down towards the left shoulder. And the inhalation brings the head back up to vertical. Now, as you continue, you may want to explore transferring the weight. So as you go down with your right ear towards your right shoulder, maybe your right hip comes up into the action a little too, and you lean a little to your left. And then as you inhale, you feel your hips coming back so that the weight is on both sit bones. And as you exhale your left ear towards your left shoulder, your weight transfers a little bit more onto your right sit bone as you lift your left hip. And you inhale back. You keep going in this movement, just exploring the feeling sense of your spine, your head, your neck, the various options of involving a little bit more of the spine and the hips as you do this motion is something that is accessible because you're sitting. It's difficult to get this movement into the spine when you are standing because you've got the weight on both legs. But as you're sitting, you can really feel that you can transfer the weight onto one sit bone so that you can lighten the other. Maybe you feel like you're almost lifting it up off the seat. So you're really folding your spine this time from side to side, making the letter C again as it is according to your feeling sense of your capacity. There's nothing you're achieving here. Just simply flexing the spine, the head and the neck, and extending it. And excuse me, once you've come through that series of movements several times, come back to your center, and this time place your hands on your legs. Relax your feet, close your eyes for a moment if they're open. Really come into the feeling sense of the breath, notice any tension in the body. And now we'll transition into Simha Kriya, the lion pose. So this is when we open our mouth, draw back our lips, and stick out our tongue towards our chin. Open our jaws, open our eyes wide, look up through the tops of the eye sockets. And relax everything. Back into the breath. And once again, we open the mouth, stick out the tongue, open the eyes. And now relax. And this time as you open your face, opening your mouth, sticking out your tongue, and opening your eyes, I want you to visualize pulling your ears back along your scalp towards your tail, drawing your shoulder blades so that they arrive more on your back, and feeling a full sense of turning your body inside out. So try that. And relax. So you feel that in that movement, you feel this sort of when it sometimes I'm reminded of those rubber change purses, which were popular in the 1960s and 70s, where they were like this rubber purse that looked a little bit like a cowrie shell. It had a slit in it, and you could turn them inside out. And so I'm looking, thinking of the body as opening up and really peeling itself back, so your heart's coming forward. So we try this now with the breath as well, Simha Kriya. So we spread the hands, palms down, we spread our claws, spread out the fingers, really feel that energetic connection through the palms and the fingers. Spread your toes and your shoes. Use the position of the hands and the arms to elevate the heart region, drawing it through. Lengthen the back of your neck by taking your chin in a little. You're already starting to come forward a little bit with your torso, as if I was going to use my knees to sit up, but I'm not going to actually do that. But the lion pose is often practiced like this, with the spine like this, and then and so when you come up just ever so slowly so that there's no strain or stress to your body. Now, I did that this time. Actually, you're rather stable in that position because you have your hands on your knees. And so you can do it in the chair. We often practice it in the chair, which is good. But if you want to see what this looks like from the side, it's like I was sitting down and then I just got up a little and my back is got this kind of shape to it. I've got my shoulder blades on my back, tucked my chin. My hands are energetic, my toes are energetic. I open my face, my eyes, stick out my tongue. And then I come up slowly. So there's that possibility as well. So when you come up slowly. And this has been shown, this practice has no counterindications for like hypertension or detached retina or glaucoma. Sometimes when you have issues with your eyes, you don't want to do these kinds of things. But this particular practice is absolutely safe. So it's very beneficial for your digestive system. And it's connected to your eyes. You'll notice that we are opening our mouth, sticking out our tongue to do that, but we're also got our eyes. So we're gonna do just a little bit of work with our eyes today, the eye exercises. So prepare by sitting tall. Just let your eyes close for a moment so they get nicely moisturized. By closing your eyes, you're able to let them